Today topic is pest of onion and garlic, right? Let's see some important points on garlic and onion. Due to its antibacterial, antifungal and antiviral properties, garlic is known to reduce inflammation and lower high blood pressure. It is even recommended for people trying to lose their weight. Coming to onion, on the other hand, remove toxins from the body, normalize digestion and are excellent to treat cold and cough. Right, let's enter the today topic, pest of onion and garlic. Right, first one is Saphir's onion thrips. This is common pest for both onion and garlic. Right, thrips tabaci, thripidae, thysanoptera. It is polypagous pest, so it will attack wide range of crop. Okay, coming to symptom, here nymphs and adult congregate in dense masses in narrow spaces between the axis of inner leaf, and it will show the fatter and the curled leaf tips, and the bulb size also reduced. Here nymph or pale yellow color, adult or with the fringed wings. Coming to biology, it has three life stages, egg, pupal, adult. Here egg period is 10 to 15 days, egg inserted into the tender leaf by lacerating the tissues. Coming to pupal period, 3 days, pupation takes place in soil. Adult, generally in yellow in color. Total life cycle is about 28 days. Coming to identification, eggs are teeny kidney shaped and white in color. Nymphs and adult are slender, fragile and yellowish in color. Adult have fringed wings heavily with fine hairs. Males are 0.8 to 1 mm long, while the females are 1 to 1.2 mm long. Okay. Right. It is major cosmopolitan thrips injuries to onion and garlic. Here nymphs and adult both are remain in dense at leaf bases and walls of onions and feed by lacerating the tissues, imbibing the oozing the cell sap. Infesting leaves develop a spotted appearance on the leaf. It will turn into a pale white blotches. In the case of severe attack, leaves dry from tip to downward. Right, it is active throughout the year, breed on different hosts during different season. Full grown nymphs fall on the ground and pupate at the depth of about 2.5 cm. Okay, coming to other species of thrips, groundnut thrips, calyo thrips indicus, blossom thrips, yellow thrips coloris, both are coming under thripidae, thysanoptera. Coming to management of thrips, we can grow the resistant variety for onions like white persia, grano, sweet spanish, crystal wax, etc. The pest can also be controlled by spraying the crop with malathion at 0.05% or dimethyote at 0.03%. After the application of insecticide, observe the waiting period of 7 days. It's very important for our wisdom. And we can go for maize 2-rows as barrier crop. We can use neem coated urea to reduce the infestation of pest. 2 to 3 sprays of NSKE 4% or 1% neem soap at 10 days interval. Sky blue color sticky trap can use to attract more adult than yellow color traps. Coming to borer, onion fly. It's Delia antiqua. Other genus name is Hylema antiqua. Family Muscidae, Autodiptera. Coming to symptom, here onion leaves get rotten, shredded and rolled up, growth of onion tubers get hampered. Tissue get decayed and becoming unfit for marketing. Right, coming to biology, it has 4 life stages, egg, maggot, pupal, adult. Egg having 5 to 7 days and it laid in soil. Maggot whitish in color. Pupal period is about 21 days. Pupation takes place in soil. Adult slender grayish with large wings. Biology of Delia antiqua. Family Muscidae, Autodiptera. You can see the 4 life stages with symptom of damages. Newly emerged maggots crawled up to the plant and enter the leaf sheath and reach the bulb. Large bulb can be attacked by many maggots, each carving out a small cavity. In the third generation, pests attack the crop near the harvest, which is responsible for rotting of bulbs in storage. For the management, we can grow the tolerant variety Allium fistulosum and treat the soil with the dust formulation carbaryl 5% D and 4-10 G followed by irrigation. And also we can go for chemical methyl dimethon 25 EC 2 ml per liter, dimethyate 30 EC on at 1 ml per liter, monocrotophos 36 SL at 1 ml per liter with the TPOL 0.5 ml. I can also go for malathion at 0.05% at 15 days interval is also effective. Coming to next important borer, that is Airwig. Anisobolus stahli, family Forficulidae, order Dermaptera. The symptom is both nymph and adult bore into the onion bulbs and cause damage. And coming to other biology, egg, nymph, adult. Here egg period is 14 days. 21 to 139 eggs can laid by this borer Airwig. Next, nymph. Nymph is white in early stages and later it will turn to brown. Nymphal period is 50 to 54 days. Adult, dark brown to black with forceps like caudal cerce in white leg joints. It has forceps like cerce. That is a identification mark for borer Airwig. Here nymphs and adults bore into the onion bulbs and feed, cause damage, economic damage. And eggs are laid in small earthen chamber below the stones or debris. Alternate host plants are groundnut and cabbage. It causes damage by boring into the onion bulb. The incubation period is 7 to 11 days and larval period is 106 to 252 days. Okay, control is we can go for drenching with chlorypyrifos at 0.04%. And other species of Airwig, you can note here other species of Airwig, that is actually other storage pest of Airwig: Anthrenes jordanicus, Dermastidae coleoptera, Anthrenes oceanicus, Dermastidae coleoptera, Alpidopicus levigatus, Tenebranidae coleoptera. Coming to management for Airwig, can use carbaryl 5% DA 25 kg per hectare. Also go for soil application of carbofuron 3G at 30 kg or Aldicarb 10G at 10 kg per hectare on 20 days after sowing and earth up. And basal application of FOM 25 tons per hectare or 250 kg per hectare of neem cake. Coming to next pest, mite, Acaria tulipa. The symptom is curling and discoloration of leaves and suck the cells sap from bulb. You can go for 2 to 3 spray of NSK 4% or 1% neem soap at 10 days interval. You can go also, you can apply the vegetable sulfur 80 WP 3 gram per liter. And next one is important polyphagous pest, that is gram caterpillar Helicorba armichera Noctuidae Leptoptera. Here it is a minor pest. The caterpillar attack fluorescence and they also bore into the stalk. You can see the life stages of Helicorba armigera: egg, larva, pupa, moth. Finally, come to the other pest, the cutworm, the Spodoptera litura, Noctuidae Leptoptera, black cutworm, Agrotis ypsilon, Noctuidae Leptoptera. These are the minor pests in the case of onion and garlic. And coming to management, for the effective management for onion thrips and onion fly, we should note the ETL level. It is 1 maggot per hill. This is a ETL level for onion thrips and onion fly. You can go for dimethyate 30% EC 7.0 ml per 10 liter of water, oxydimethon methyl 25% EC 1.2 ml per liter, பாஸ்பாமிடான் 85 WSC 0.5 ml, குயினால்ஃபாஸ் 25% ஈசி 1.2 ml per liter. And coming to management for onion cutworm, you can go for effective one, that is trench. Trench the soil with chloripyrifos at 2 ml per liter and triazophos at 2 ml per liter. Note here, profenophos likely to cause the phytotoxicity, so we have to go for pre-testing is must. And coming to garlic thrips, aridity level is 10 thrips per plant up to 40 days after sowing, 20 thrips per plant after 40 days after sowing. Here avoid your excess nitrogen and close spacing, and grow resistant variety like UT1 garlic, and go for chemicals, the dimethyl 400 ml per acre and asafoetid 200 gram per acre, phosphomidone 200 ml per acre. Here while spraying, focus the spray fluid at the walls of the plant. It's very important because of the sap feeder. So focus the whole part of the garlic to control the effective control the thrips or sap feeders. Here I end my presentation. Thank you.